Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we continue with the series of I'm doing about RAG, retrieval augmented generation. And in today's video, we will see how to use LangChain to extract information from PDF and return this information in a structured manner. So what means is that we are going to use an LLM to query the information that we extract from PDFs, and we are interested in extracted information in some pieces of information from the documents, which usually we consider kind of like a record, which later on we will be used to either feed another upstream application, kind of or like a database, or being the input in a second phase of another LLM or another component or agent, like the stat that we saw days ago, where we use structured data in combination with the pandas agent in LangChain to build or to extract information about the data, for example, correlation in between different columns, etc., etc. So the idea is for some in some scenarios it's important to extract information in a structured manner, because this information is going to be part of the or input of another component, another step in the pipeline, and we need to be consistent and systematic on the way that we extract information, and the data types that are used and the completeness of the information is there or not. These kind of controls in some scenarios are very important, especially when you need to use information in a posterior step of the or your data transformation pipeline or your data pipeline. So today we are going to use again LangChain together with Gemini Pro and also the integration that we had available in LangChain, and to enforce the data types we will use Pydantic. Pydantic is, well, probably the most widely used data, but it's true, no? It's probably you are using Pydantic, and in most of the applications that you build with Python today, for example, Fast API, most of these SDKs that we use to access the models are using Pydantic as well. Everything practically today is using Pydantic, which allow us and help us to enforce the data type, and also is broadly used at the time that you create interfaces in different components. Not necessarily the components have to run in Python, they can be run in other languages, but it's very important, especially when you have interfaces with other systems, to enforce the data type and the data schema, because this is what we say in data engineering, data contract, and then this data contract has to be set up in both sides of the elements of the components that are exchanging information, and then only it's working or it has to be done in many scenarios in and out. So it has to be a contract from the information that you receive in, and also for the information that you receive out. No? Also, this is used when you are reading data from a storage, from receiving data via HTTP or via a feed or via an event, whatever. All the information that you are reading from these sources, usually you implement or enforce a data type, and this is usually done with Pydantic. So we will use Pydantic as well today for that purpose, to enforce and to parse the information that and to help as well to provide this data schema to the LLM as context and also as instructions of for output formatting, in order to finally get an object from the text with the adequate format and ready to be used for an upstream application. So as usual, I have prepared an output that later on I will upload to the repository as usual as well, and I will pass you as well the requirements. This is essentially the same that we used for previous videos, where we essentially do the agent, the pandas agent, and also the video that we were discussing how to speak with your documents in few words, no? how to use Gemini and LangChain and other tools like vector stores to extract to get valuable information from your documents, not only PDFs, also images or Excel, like was the case of the video I recorded before. So again, I pass you here some important links or interesting links, just to you get some background on the topic. Here we just import the stuff we need, the most relevant intents of Pydantic. We import the output parser, which is the class Pydantic output parser. Here we are going to use the Chat Google Generative AI class, the integrated on the LAN Google Gemini class from community from the community LangChain community library, and then we will use from Pydantic finally the base model, which is essentially the something similar for those that are familiar with data class in Python. This is something very similar, a little bit more strict and more Pythonic, if you want to say, than the data class. And well, it's done with that purpose essentially, and the field, which is essentially defining the attributes. I'm gonna use today is just an introduction to LangChain LangSmith, this tool which help us to do debugging and monitor the execution of our chains. I'm just going to show you how it looks like. We will do a video specifically for how to use LangSmith, and today you want to use it. If you are already familiar with that, well, you probably know as well how to log in. You have to create an account in LangSmith and get an API key, and well, if you want to LangSmith monitor what's going on with your chains, just do something similar to what you see on the screen. Again, you will need to generate a key, and then you will have to have these two environment variables if you want to LangSmith register what happened with your chains. Okay. In terms of Pydantic, you have to be aware that sometimes it's quite tricky work with Pydantic, because new versions sometimes, or better say, all versions doesn't have the new attributes, and as I said before, most of this library that you are seeing here, they are using Pydantic, or they are compatible with Pydantic, or they are using Pydantic, but they may have compatibility with Pydantic in a previous version. So sometimes it's a little bit tricky, especially if you set up the latest version. So that's why I will pass you my requirements TST in case that if you have problems. This is working. Sometimes you have an old version of this library installed, sometimes it's a little bit difficult to make them work together. But yeah, this is because Pydantic is in constant evolution. The same that the other libraries, to be honest. But yeah, well, sometimes it's depending on which compatibility the library has with Pydantic, it's a little bit tricky because of the new functionalities that they are implemented. Because also at the same time, the Pydantic has to be consistent with the Python version that you are working with. In my case, I'm working with Python 3.11, and well, again, sometimes it's a little bit tricky, and well, just to you be aware of that, it could be a potential source of problems. I'm using, as I said, Gemini 1.5 Pro, using this Invertex AI in Google Cloud Platform. So I'm accessing the model via with a service account. So I have my account exported in JSON. This is explained in many videos. We had a complete series of Vertex AI on the channel. So if you had any problems how to set up the access to Vertex AI, write me a comment in the comments of this video. And I will try to help you with the problem. Here we don't need this, so probably better to remove it. I will do it before I upload the video to the repo. So we use PY PDF loader to load our data. Here we have the PDF. It's essentially a PDF from this Excel. I'm working in a data extraction from this, usually the information come to me in Excel or in PDF format, but essentially the PDF is essentially the printout of all these sheets, and then on every sheet contain information of the companies that are reported here in entity name. It's information related to the registry. And then on the idea is, in my case, that is my requirements to pass the name of a company. In this case, for example, Yuga Studio, Partner Markets, and retrieve all the information of all these sheets. And if the information code in PDFs, I will receive the same, but in PDF format. So, say 6-7 pages, 8 pages, but in PDF, like you can see here. I just doing the initial test with one page only, but well, it's gonna be the same for the rest. So the idea is, again, pass the name of a company and extract the rest across the different pages. So all the pages has kind of ID, which is the name of the company, and then we can use it to add like a key for the different information hosted in the different sheets. So we load the page as you PY PDF loader is from LangChain community document loaders. So this essentially is extracting all the pages from your PDF and converting every single page in a LangChain document. What you get here It's just simply a document LangChain which contain two main attributes, the metadata, which is a dictionary with some metadata. In this case, it's just producing the name of the file and the page, and the name of the page content, which is the text extracted from this PDF. Then we use some classes from LangChain to create the prompts, and here we create the data class in or the, it's the model, the data model. We use we create a class, and we heritage or derivate the class from base model, and then on you define the name of the attributes that you want to extract. And here optionals means that it is the model doesn't sorry, you don't it can be null in few words, and here is the data type, string, integer, etc. Then on the field there is a description of the field, which also will help the model to understand what it had to look for. And there is, you can set up as well the for value. In this case, I don't set up, but maybe in your case, if you find the information it is null, you can set up a default value, and this is the purpose of the having this parameter here. I made a try, but this didn't work. It just to you can use this in two different ways. The way I do it is as I pass a name of the company to the as input of my chain, and it extracts all the information from the document. But there is also another possibility, that is create a prompt which extract all the entities that match with a data class. This can be done with a nesting different Pydantic classes. And then, as you can see here, I create a class data, also derivate from base model, and it has only an attribute, which is a list of entity data extraction. Again, this is another possibility. You need to change. I put you the code here, just to, if you want to use it that way. So this means that I will extract from the first page all the entities that match with my content. It's not the way I'm gonna use it, but if you want to use it, you can do it that way. So once you have the classes defined, you can print the schema. This is a method from the class base model in Pydantic. You can see here, this is part of the stuff that we will pass to the model, to the model understand what he had to look for and how the model had to format it before to return it to the user. So here, this we can remove it. It's not really neat for that. We create a parser. This parser is coming from the Pydantic output parser. We pat the class, is the entity data class extension, and we create a prompt with in messages. We had the message prompt template, and then here we pat the format instruction. This is created on the fly at the execution time, and we pass the question. The question is our input. So the parser get format instruction. If you print out, you can see here, this is how he had to extract information, how he had to match the data type, and so on and so forth. And then we create the prompt, we instantiate our model, and then essentially we create an instruction, pass from information of company Yuga Studios, and we pass the content of the page 0, or we only had one page, so the page, the text of the page 0 is the information that we pass together with the with the question. We formatted the prompt, as you can see here, question equal document query. So here we will answer the user question as best as possible about the name of the company requested. We pass the format question and we pass the question that is this together with the content, the page content. So we invoke the model, and then once we had the output, we parse the model with our parser. So we are going to execute it again. So we just simply print this, tag, tag, tag. We pass the document query. And you can see here, what we receive is an entity data extraction object. And then you can parse this, you can convert it to a JSON and load it with JSON again just to print out correctly. If we look at the Excel file, let's put it together here, Yuga Studios, you can check committee, ATIT, blah, blah, blah. 2017-04-09, country Russia, St. Petersburg, null, false, register office, 20 Nevsky Prospect, St. Petersburg, blah, 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 Russia, and 17 Bolshaya Moskaya Street, St. Petersburg, 190,000 Russia. So it was correct. So you can check here JSON as well. We try with now with another company and well, it's gonna work as well. Be sure our model is working pretty well. And you can check now is Youthcoin Trash Dorman. This is the tax ID, known exactly, corporation date 2013-02-06, UK, Greater London 2022-06-14, true, and now Baker Street 221B, Baker Street, London, blah, 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 United Kingdom, and 12 Downing Street. Well, this is the house of the Prime Minister. I don't think that the house is there, but well, it's... Or it's the 10, no, it's the 10 Downing Street, not the 12. But well, I don't think that the company is sitting there. It's just probably fake values. But yeah, in any case, you can now replicate the model, create models for any of the other sheets, and just extract information. And yeah, here a pointing record code, blah blah blah, and started to extract from the other sheets. In my case, in this case, for other PDFs similar to this. Again, you have here this option. This option is simply that instead to set the name of a company and extract the data for that company, here the plan is to create a list. You here I pass the prompt to the model with the structure output, and I pass the data. The data was the second model, which is essentially a list of the strict entity data extraction. And this is the idea here is to produce a list of all objects. As the model is defined very flexible, very weak enforcement. You can, you have different levels of enforcement. You can just say, if you don't find one of the fees or some of the fees that are mandatory, don't produce the record. This is something that you can, configure in your model. And also, obviously, it will impact in the output of your, of your query, no? When do this, essentially, this will be part of the schema, and then on this will be something that it will kind of an instruction of context that will be sent to the model, and the model will act accordingly to what is finding into in the information of the model. There is a lot of information here. It's really, really detailed the way that you can set up the data enforcement with the, you can see here, Hugging Face, everything is using today Pydantic. And then again, the way that they are doing this is quite so they enforce, you have different ways to enforce, from very weak enforcement, but in any case it had to be a data types, you can say that the data is optional, not optional, but the objects at the end, when you set up a model, have to have this the structure that you define, even if the data is null or you set up the false, no? And then you can also set up some checks or verifications when you parse the data. Is a completely different world. No? We had to do an explanation, complete explanation of Pydantic. We can spend 2 or 3 videos explaining all the possibilities that we had there. So it's not the matter. You had interest. You had a very extensive documentation, which at the same time, depending on the version of the of Python you had, it may work slightly different, because every version of Python is the newest versions are more and more how to say, they enforce more and more the data type. The oldest versions, like 3.8 or 2.7, even, which probably I think not many people is using today, but they were not very quickly enforced data type on that versions. Okay, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting and useful for whatever reason that you watching this video, for your job, for your training. It doesn't really matter. Thank you very much. And if you like it and you find it interesting and useful, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and if you didn't do it before, and share with your friends or colleagues, and make comments and all this stuff to help me to grow YouTube. Thank you very much, and see you soon.